Speaker, I rise to make the statement on the year of return, commemorating 400th anniversary of the transatlantic slave trade and celebrating African resilience. Mr. Speaker, the year 2019 marks 400 years since the first enslaved Africans were transported from Africa to North America, landing at the fledgling English colony of Jamestown, Port Comfort, Virginia. The Ghanaian coastline is today dotted with imposing European forts, harboring harrowing reminders of the intense and complex history of the transatlantic slave trade in our land over centuries. This on its own makes Ghana a focus for millions of African descendants reacting to their marginalization by tracing their ancestry and their identity. However, even more important is the recognition of Ghana as a beacon for African people living on the continent and in the diaspora. This status has been earned not by coincidence, but by conscious effort to validate the struggles, strengths, and links between African descendants on a pan-African scale. Mr. Speaker, in September 2018, after a successful local launch, the President of the Republic, His Excellency Nana Addo-Dankwa Akufo-Addo, proclaimed the year 2019 as the year of return at the Washington Press Club with business, political, and media leaders in attendance. In the U.S., Congress has passed H.R. 1242 to establish a commission and develop activities to commemorate the 400th year. Despite the torture of our ancestors and the inhumane conditions they endured, we celebrate the resilience of the African spirit and the achievements of our African brothers and sisters in the New World Order. Mr. Speaker, in sports, politics, entertainment, business, and religion, leading African figures have blazed the trail. Barack Obama, the first black president of the United States of America, Jesse Owens, Michael Jackson, Usain Bolt, W.E. Du Bois, Marcus Garvey, Carl Lewis, Reverend Jesse Jackson, Oprah Winfrey, Muhammad Ali, among several others, are Africans who have stood out for outstanding achievements. Mr. Speaker, the year of return shows proactive sensitivity of this country to the importance of showcasing resilience and achievements of African descendants living outside the continent through the ages to the present and into the future. This year, the Steering Committee of the Year of Return, coordinated by the Ghana Tourism Authority, has endorsed over 78 events to welcome our brothers and sisters. Other members of the Steering Committee are the Office of Diaspora Affairs, at the Office of the President, the PanAfest Foundation, and the Edinkra Group, amongst others. The Year of Return Secretariat is housed at the Accra Tourism Information Center, and a special website, www.yearofreturn.com, has been set up to provide information and updates. Through the efforts of the Steering Committee and collaboration with other ministries and agencies, we have used the Year of Return to address some of the heating issues around our visa processes. Mr. Speaker, between the 3rd to the 6th of July 2019, the Ghana Diaspora Celebration and Homecoming Summit was held in Accra. The summit, which was addressed by His Excellency the President, was one of several platforms provided for business networking, investment matchmaking, and dialogue on the rights of abode and citizenship. The summit has been institutionalized in recognition of the great impact that diasporan communities have on the growth and development of their countries. Mr. Speaker, in a few weeks, Ghana will host PanAfest and Emancipation celebrations expected to attract attendance by several African diaspora. Panafest, which was first celebrated in 1992, has endured as a reminder of Ghana's Pan-African legacy, together with the celebration of emancipation and the Joseph Project, initiated by the late Honorable Jake Obechebi Lamte, former Minister of Tourism and Diaspora Relations. A film, Joseph, will be premiered in his memory in November this year as part of the Year of Return activities. Mr. Speaker, in August 2019, we will also be welcoming members of the NAACP of Jamestown at Jamestown, Accra, to signify the exact 400-year date, 20th August 1619 to 20th August 2019, when the first arrival of slaves occurred in Jamestown, Virginia. Mr. Speaker, the implementation of the Year of Return program has helped position Ghana as a key market for the diaspora and tap into the growing African diaspora investment and travel market. Most leading international media outlets, including the BBC, CNN, Essence Magazine, Ebony, have listed Ghana as a preferred destination for 2019. From both the tourism arrivals and expenditure standpoint, we are expecting an increase of 20 to 25%. The program of events organized has helped form linkages for investment in the country, as well as highlighted available investment opportunities for people of African descent. Mr. Speaker, I want to use this opportunity to thank His Excellency the President for his exemplary leadership and the interest he has shown in this Year of Return project. Mr. Speaker, I would also like to invite our Honorable Members of Parliament to follow his lead and be Year of Return ambassadors and promote the significance of this year to the African struggle and Ghana's role as a beacon of the Pan-African movement. We invite you to the event of Panafest and Emancipation happening in Asimprasso, Accra, Anumabo, Asinmanso, Elmina, and Cape Coast Castles. A grand debut of chiefs will be held at the Cape Coast Sports Stadium on the 27th of July, 2019. Mr. Speaker, on 3rd July 2019, the official Year of Return cloth was unveiled at the Ghana Diaspora Homecoming Celebration and officially presented to the President. Each Member of Parliament will today receive a Year of Return cloth, and I invite all members to wear the cloth and be part of the celebration. Thank you, Mr. Speaker, for the opportunity.